Good evening students. Today we are going to discuss about the continuation class of punctuation. Today we are going to do some exercise. Students, please don't write in the notebook. Instead of that, take your grammar textbook and take page number 69. The question will be there. Just start the exercise and do your work, okay? Let's start the question. Take exercise B, question, read the heading, put commas in the correct places. Okay, start the question number 1. We went for a picnic. We took sandwiches, cake, bananas and lemon juice. So where we supposed to use commas? Commas whenever a sentence has one or more items, we supposed to use comma. Okay, so based on that definition, just check kids where it's supposed to be. We went for a picnic, full stop already is given. Next, we took sandwiches, cake, bananas and lemon juice. Okay, here two or more list are there. We supposed to use comma here. So after sandwiches, after cake, but don't write comma before and, the conjunction word. Before this conjunction word, we should not add comma. Next, move on to second question. I like playing football, hide and seek, cricket and badminton. Here let's find out where is one or more list are here. Football, hide and seek, cricket and badminton. Okay students, let's find out where we supposed to use comma here. After football, hide and seek, after hide and seek, then after cricket, we should not use comma because and is there. Before and, we should not use comma. So what is the answer? I like to playing football, comma, hide and seek, comma, cricket and badminton, full stop. This is the answer for this second question. Next, move on to third question. There is a sofa, an armchair, a table and a lamp in the sitting room. Here students, find out one or more items where it's supposed to be. A sofa, an armchair, a table, a lamp. Okay, where you should put comma here? After a sofa, after an armchair, that's all. Don't write comma over here because and is there. What is the answer for this third question? There is a sofa, comma, an armchair, comma, a table and a lamp in the sitting room. This is the answer for this third question. Next, move on to fourth question. Roses, dahlias, sunflowers, marigolds and hollyhocks are all flowers. Here they have given two or more flowers, okay, two or more items is there. So where we supposed to use comma? After roses, after dahlias, after sunflowers, and don't add comma over here because and is there. Okay, so what is the answer? Roses, comma, dahlias, comma, sunflowers, comma, marigolds and hollyhocks and all flowers. This is the answer for this fourth question. Next, move on to last question, fifth one. I drew pictures of flower, butterflies, trees, mountains and rivers. Okay, let's find out where is the two or more items are there. Flower, butterflies, trees, mountains and rivers. Okay, where we should use comma here? After flower, after butterflies, after trees, but don't add before and comma here. Okay, don't add comma before this conjunction word and. Okay, what is the answer for this fifth question? I drew pictures of flower, comma, butterflies, comma, trees, comma, mountains and rivers. Okay, that's all about the answers for exercise B. Let's move on to next exercise. Students, please be with same page, page number 69. Okay, next discuss about exercise C. First, read the heading, put full stop, commas, question marks and capital letters wherever needed in these sentences. Okay, we are going to write the complete sentence now. Okay, first question, I went to visit a zoo yesterday. Students, first check, keep it in your mind, what type of sentence is this? Just check. I went to visit a zoo yesterday. This is a statement, simple sentence. Okay, so we should start with capital I. Always we should start with capital letter. So I have written I went to visit a zoo yesterday. At last, what we supposed to put at last? Is it question mark? No, because this is a statement, simple sentence. We should not put question mark. So we supposed to write full stop. Then next, move on to second question. Meeta has her class test on Monday, Thursday and Friday. So first think about what type of sentence is this. Is it question type of sentence? No, this is simple type of sentence. Okay, and also when before we use this sort of punctuation marks, we must check, is there anything, one or more items is there? Just check. Monday, Thursday and Friday. So we should use comma over here. And also one more thing, whenever we could find out the letter, that means names, places, if we find out, we should use capital letter, but they have given small m here. Okay, so whenever we are writing days, Monday, Friday, Thursday, like this, we supposed to start with capital letter. Okay, so start writing the answer. Starts with capital letter. Meeta has her class test on, so this is, we have to use capital letter for days. So we should always use capital letter for days of the week. Okay? Monday, after that put comma, because one or more days are there. So we should use comma over here. Monday, then Thursday and Friday. At last, don't forget to write full stop over here. Please, children, don't forget to put full stop or question mark, whatever needs, don't forget to write here. Okay? So, what is the answer for this second question? Meeta has her class test on Monday, comma, Thursday and Friday, full stop. Okay? Next, move on to third question. Will you go to the market tomorrow? This is a question. First, think, what type of sentence is this? Will you go to the market tomorrow? This is a question type of sentence. So, we must use question mark punctuation over here. Okay? Let's start the answer. First letter should be in capital letter. So, write capital W. Will you go to the market tomorrow? At the end, what we supposed to use here? That is question mark. We should not use full stop or comma over here. We should use question mark for question type of sentence. Okay? When we try to ask something, we must use question mark at the end. Okay? Next, move on to fourth question. Shayan had 2 eggs, bread and jam for breakfast. This is not a question type of sentence. This is a simple sentence. Okay? That is statement. Okay. Then let's find out, is there anything one or more items have given? That is eggs, bread, jam are here. Eggs, bread, jam. Three things are here. So we should use comma over here. Let's start the answer. First letter always in capital letter. So Shayan had 2 eggs, comma. Don't forget to write comma, kids. Eggs, comma, bread and jam for breakfast. So at last, we should put full stop. Don't forget to put full stop over here. Okay? So what is the answer for this fourth question? That is, Shayan had 2 eggs, comma, bread and jam for breakfast. So before and, we should not use comma. We should not write comma before and. Okay? So that this is the answer for this fourth question. And last question, Kolkata is a beautiful city. What type of sentence is this? This is statement. This is a simple type of sentence. Let's start the answer. First letter should be in capital, but they have given small letter. But we supposed to write capital letter. Kolkata is a beautiful city. At last, we have to use full stop. We have to put full stop. Students, this is today's homework. Okay, please complete this one and also please practice at home. Okay, thank you.